Hi, I'm attorney Eric Johnson, and with this video, I'll introduce and explain child support in Utah to you. Let's first address three of the most common questions about child support in Utah. First, how much child support will the court order? Second, how long does child support last? And third, how is child support enforced? All of these questions and others, along with the answers, are covered in more detail on our website, so please refer to those too. How is child support in Utah calculated? I'm going to try to explain it both accurately and simply, but even then, it can get somewhat complex. But don't worry, I'm going to give you the link to our online child support calculator a little later on in this video. I still encourage you to follow my explanations so you'll understand the policy behind child support. Child support is almost always based upon Utah's statutory formula. Utah uses what are known as statutory guidelines. Generally, each parent's child support obligation is established in proportion to gross monthly incomes. Gross monthly incomes, not your net income. That means child support is based on every penny you're paid without subtracting taxes or any personal expenses from your or your spouse's income. Using the gross amount helps prevent the parties from manipulating their incomes to report an income that is lower or higher than it truly is. Without getting too technical or complex, to calculate child support, you take the total of each parent's gross income and determine what percentage of your combined income the statutory guidelines devote to financial support for the children each month. For example, let's assume you have three children and you earn $5,000 a month and your ex earns or could earn $1,700 per month. When the parents' combined gross monthly income is $6,700, as it is in this case, then Utah's child support guidelines say that parents whose combined income is $6,700 a month are obligated to spend $1,565 of that amount on the financial support of your children each month. Because you earn 75% of the parents' combined income, you are also responsible to pay 75% of the $1,565 in child support each month. By the same token, your ex who earns 25% of the combined parental income is responsible for 25% of child support. Do you get that? That should make sense. Utah has both parents contribute to their children's financial support in proportion to the amount of money each parent earns or takes in. This is why some parents end up paying child support and why others end up receiving child support. Let me illustrate with this example. Imagine that your children, those three children we're talking about, lived an equal amount of time with you and with your ex each month. You earn and pay 75% of the kids' financial support, but they aren't with you 75% of the time. They're with you only 50% of the month. That would leave you with more money than days to spend it on. Likewise, the children also spend half of the month with your ex, but your ex is responsible for only 25% of child support, so that means your ex would run out of money to support the children before the end of the month. So to ensure that the same amount of money is available for the support of the children, you would be ordered to pay your ex the difference. That way, theoretically, each parent has enough money to maintain the children's lifestyle financially each day of the month. Here's another example. If you and your spouse make the same amount of money, but the kids spend most of their time with you, you would get child support paid to you. Now, I used these examples to help you understand some basic concepts behind calculating child support obligations. To use our child support calculator, you need to know how much money you and your ex gross every month. You need to know how many kids you have together, whether you or your spouse have any other support orders for other children besides those of the marriage, and how many days the children of your marriage live with each of you each year. Now, here is the address on our website for the child support calculator. I will leave it up here for the rest of this video so you can jot it down and type it into your browser. Once you understand the policy behind child support and know how to enter the proper data into the child support calculator, you will answer the questions as to how much child support you'll have to pay or how much child support you will receive. Make sure you input gross income. Gross income includes not only salaries, wages, commissions, royalties, bonuses, and earned income, but income other than what's in your paycheck, such as royalties, rents, gifts, prizes, dividends, severance pay, pensions, interest, trust income, alimony from previous marriages, annuities, capital gains, social security benefits, workers' compensation benefits, unemployment compensation, income replacement disability insurance benefits, and payments from non-means-tested government programs where income is not a qualifier for receiving assistance. Now let's switch gears and talk about how long child support can last in Utah. Child support typically lasts until a child becomes 18 years of age or graduates from high school during the child's normal and expected year of graduation, whichever occurs later. Or if the child dies, marries, becomes a member of the armed forces of the United States, or is legally emancipated by court order. Child support can, in rare circumstances, be extended to the age of 21, but that usually arises only when a child is mentally or physically handicapped. I have yet to see a case where child support was ordered beyond the age of 18 for an able-bodied person of normal intelligence. So for those of you who are wondering whether courts in Utah order parents to pay for college for their adult-age children, the answer is the courts can do it, but I have never seen it done personally. Even though college is generally not something that a judge will order parents to pay for their adult children, it is something the parents can agree will be ordered if they want to make that a part of their settlement agreement. Now to answer the third question. How is child support enforced in Utah? Child support is a serious matter. Unless the government enforces payment of child support, that leaves the government to take care of the children using taxpayer money. So the government is highly motivated to ensure child support is paid. To enforce payment of child support, Utah, and every other state in this country, has at least one government agency to help parents who are owed child support collect it. Utah's Office of Recovery Services and the Utah court system can garnish wages, intercept tax refunds, criminally prosecute and jail delinquent parents, revoke their driver's license, professional license, and even their recreational licenses. The government makes it very easy for itself and for parents to collect child support so that children do not become welfare charges. While you certainly can hire an attorney to help you pursue the collection of child support, the state government agencies I've talked about provide help for you for little to no money because helping collect child support often saves more money than it costs the government. To find out how the Office of Recovery Services, or ORS as it is also known, can help you, here is their website address, which I will leave up until this video is over so that you can jot it down and type that into your browser. We have other videos and articles on the subject of child support on this site, and I encourage you to view those as well to help you better understand child support and all the forms it takes in Utah divorce and child custody cases.